afternoon baseball now from the Juice Box, Minute Maid Park in Houston. Here it's the little guys on the big stage between the Scranton-Wilkes-Barre Rail Riders and the Sugar Land Skeeters.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome your Sugar Land Skeeters.
Now at the plate is Tim LoCastro. He will lead this one off today. Pitch on the way. Late swing there at the breaking ball. Must have been looking for something else. Should be a picture perfect afternoon for baseball. 78 degrees at first pitch.
Put that in a memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Now a swing and a miss on the slider as the leadoff man is set down on strikes to open up the ball game. So now to the plate, Andrew Velasquez, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
And this isn't his strong side, at least not in terms when you look at the stat sheet or his consistent contact rates. I just don't think he's quite as smooth with his rhythm and swing mechanics when he's hitting left-handed.
And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
That is third. The first baseman, Chris.
In now, Chris Gittens. And this is taken for a called strike, and he's not in love with that call either. It's one and two now. Fouled away. Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. The second for one, on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. And stepping in, Ross Adolph. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now the payoff pitch home. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Reined in. He'll take it to the bag himself, and the leadoff man is gone here to start the home first. So one down, no one aboard. And into bat next, the utility man extraordinaire Marwin Gonzalez. Takes that one a little bit low. Three balls and a strike now.
3-1. Three balls, one strike.
Fastball is taken for a strike, and he runs it full, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. And he missed with that one. It's ball four. A one-out walk here in the home first. Up next, Ronnie Dawson. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Hit back toward the mound. To second for one, but they won't get two as he beats the relay to first. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Taylor Jones. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Here comes the 1-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Long run for the right fielder. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. So here's the cleanup hitter, Clint Frazier. He'll be the one to greet Justin Verlander to start the inning. And he fouls this one off. Again, a 1-2. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. 2-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Hit out towards second. On first, and there's one gone here to start the second. Now one down with the bases empty, and that'll bring up the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Into center field, line drive base hit. Legs churning, he's headed for second. And he'll pull into second with one away.
That is good. The right fielder, Esteban.
Stepping in now, Esteban Florial. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Hit in the air down the right field line. Right fielder is on the run, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. So a man at second here with two away. And striding into the plate, it'll be Miguel Andujar. The set and the 1-1. Here's one a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now. Breaking ball, and he gets him to chase it in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Striding in is number 13. He'll get his first shot with the bat here. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second.
Batting fifth.
So next to hit is Jordan Brewer. Count remains 2-2. A runner at first with no outs here. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. So the next to bat will be Preudis Nova. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone. The 1-1 pitch. Lifted in the air out to left field. Frazier is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. So next to bat will be Robel Garcia. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. So a full count now.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And a fastball called strike three, and the side is retired. Now at the plate here is Mandy Alvarez, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. The 1-1.
That's the ball.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away. Next to hit, Rob Brantley. Gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone, 1-2. And it's fouled away. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Now back
to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Tim LoCastro. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Hey, struggling to find the release point of that curveball. That wasn't a very good one. Somehow he's just got to find that feel, because that's a pitch he's going to need going forward.
Two balls and two strikes now. The 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Bottom of the third now, and now it'll be the catcher, Garrett Stubbs. Now the pitch. Swing and a line drive, but this is going to land foul, so they'll tee it up again, 3-2. hit softly down the line at first. Fielded cleanly, and he'll step on first himself for the out. And now here is Ross Adolph. He bounced out last time up. Halfway to 100 pitches, here it is. Fouled off. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. And he'll hang in here as he reaches to foul this one away. Swing and a miss got him reaching. Brantley has it, and the throw is made to record the second out of the inning. Next to dig in, Marwin Gonzalez worked a walk his first time up.
This could be a huge win for the guy on the mound if he's able to get out of this inning 1-2-3 and start fresh next inning with the middle of the order.
And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Ball three. 3-2 now.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Fouled away. The 3-2 one more time. Down the left field line and deep. And that will end up a foul ball.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Frazier finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Set for the start of the fourth, and coming forward now is the shortstop Andrew Velasquez.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
Popped him up, and this is taken in for out number one. Digging in will be Chris Gittens. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Oh, textbook slider there, and he's back at even 2-2. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2. The pitch. And that is swung on and missed. He's down on strikes, and the first two are retired here to begin inning number four. So the bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Clint Frazier. Tried to get that one airborne, but it's 1-2. And Ben, that's a pretty good example of why he's such a great pitcher.
Yeah, stuff. Stuff is obviously the important key to being dominant on the mound, but it doesn't mean a whole lot if you don't have outstanding control to go along with it.
Looking at a fastball to end the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Ronnie Dawson. High in the air down the right field line. Long run for the right fielder, and he makes the catch in the corner.
Now back.
So here is Taylor Jones, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Velasquez ranging into the outfield. He gets there, and that's the second out. Next to hit is number 13, who drew a base on balls his first time up. And a change up here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Hit in the air down the right field line. Florial on the run. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And set to go is the switch hitting outfielder, Aaron Hicks. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. On the ground to third. And that'll get by into left field, so he's on to lead off the inning.
Now back, the right fielder, Esteban.
At the plate now, Esteban Florial. Count still at 1-2. From the belt, the pitch.
2-2
Hicks aboard here at first with nobody out. Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame. Here's Miguel Andujar now looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
The count now at 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Popped him up. Jones moving to his left. And that's the second out of the inning. Now to bat, Mandy Alvarez struck out in his first at bat. Two out with the man at first. Taken but called the strike.
Great job on those last two pitches of varying speeds. Gave him a hard fastball and then he locked him up with a changeup.
And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
2-2.
And he fouls this one off. The 2-2 one more time. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. And now in the box, Jordan Brewer. He went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
He somehow gets that one by him. 3-2 now. Swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Another ball. Good job. Freyudis. No ball.
Standing in now, Freyudis Nova. And that one yanked just foul. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Frazier has him played perfectly as he puts it away for out number one. Striding forward now is the DH, Robert Garcia. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Maddie, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got to bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot. Has to put the ball in play.
Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Here's the 1-1. Hit to short. Right to him. So they do get their first hit, but their first run will have to wait as the inning is over. Stepping up is Rob Brantley, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. And another foul ball. Here he comes again, 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now.
Don't be surprised if he gets another back foot slider right here. Don't think for a second just because he took the first one that this pitcher won't come back exactly the same way.
And here's a ball hit in the air. Jones trying to get there, but this is going to wind up a foul ball. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
Second base.
So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Tim LoCastro, going to strike that victim twice in this one. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, and this is going to wind up a foul ball.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch. Wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
2-2 the count. From the belt, kicks and deals. On the ground is short. This could be two. He's got it. Gonzalez for one. Hey. On to first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw.
Now batting.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Andrew Velasquez. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Throw over to the bag, and he has to dive, but he's back in easily. The 2-2. High in the air down the right field line. And foul. LoCastro, base runner at first with one out. Runner's going. Swing and a miss, strike three. The throw. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down. Next up is Chris Gittens. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. Ready with the 1-1. 1-2 now. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ballgame, and this one ends the inning. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and standing in the outfielder, Ross Adolph. The 1-1. Tries to go the other way as this is in the air to left field. Frazier moves over a few steps to his right as he's got it for the first out. Here's Marwin Gonzalez now. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. The 3-2 pitch. And it's fouled away. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk. Nick Nelson enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. Ronnie Dawson will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. 3-1.
Full count.
Swung on and missed. A full count now. Pops this one up. And that's going to land foul. The next 3-2. Saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air. And he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for out number two.
The bat.
Next to stand in is Taylor Jones. Flew out last time. Still 1-2. Has a look, now the pitch. Hit hard on the ground to second. Speared on the dive. It's there, and he's out. Seventh inning ready to roll, and next it'll be the outfielder, Clint Frazier. Now the 2-1 pitch. He's just rolling right now, and even dozen strikeouts for him in the ballgame.
Now that one.
Digging in next, Aaron Hicks. Last time through was a base hit. Here now the 2-2. Gets him looking up around the letters. And that'll bring in Esteban Florial. 0-for-2 for him to this point.
Esteban
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. 2-1.
That missed. That's the ball.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now. 3-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
And that's in there, so perhaps some life here with two men out. To the plate now, Miguel Andujar. And he misses with it, ball four, so the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now.
The third baseman.
Now to the plate here is Mandy Alvarez. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. He's set. The 3-2. Now that's popped up. Jones has a play. He hauls it in, and the potential go-ahead run will not come around to score. Now into the box, number 13. He flew out in his last AB. Misses ball two. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one. Now at the plate, Jordan Brewer, a hit and two at bats for him at this point in the ballgame.
Brewer.
The 1-1. Hit out towards second. Scooped up. Throw gets him. That's two down. Ready now is Freudis Nova. 0 for 2. He's flown out twice. The 1-1. Is looked at for ball number two.
Hey, after those two breaking balls missed, you have to be sitting on a fastball right here.
Too high that time, and it's 3-1. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. Into the Crawford boxes and gone. Into the box now, Robel Garcia. And a fastball misses there, ball four. Stepping in next, Garrett Stubbs, grounded out in his last at bat. A 1-1. Sent on the ground out to second. He's right there, and an underhanded throw is in time for out number three. Nolly Paredes has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 48.
So now here is Rob Brantley. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now. Into the windup and the pitch. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
Now batting.
At the plate now is Tim LoCastro. 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. And he missed with it. Ball four. So that means now the potential tying run will move into scoring position at second.
71.
Now it'll be Andrew Velasquez. A base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Brewer is there to make the catch, and that's a big out number one. So stepping in is Chris Gittens, trying here to plate the tying run from second. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes.
Number three hole hitter up right now. Cleanup guy on deck. Two ball, two strike count. I think pitcher wants to make something happen right here.
2-2. A swing and a liner to left center field, and that's going to drop in for a base hit. And the run will score from second as this ball game is tied one apiece. Pedro Baez takes the mound to try to get out of this mess. There are two on with only one away. So now to the plate, Clint Frazier. Called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's 1-2 now. Now a swing and a fly ball. And foul. Now another 1-2. Again, he sends it out of play.
Those are the pitches in the game that you don't get back as an offensive player. I know it's easy sitting up here in the booth calling the game, but he'll be thinking about that one for a while if he doesn't get a hit in this at-bat right here.
Again, another foul ball. Another 1-2. And now this will be the 10th pitch of the at-bat. A little low, it's 2-2.
Tough to take a pitch like that right there, especially in a 1-2 count. You almost get in that auto swing mode. Great job to work the count back to even.
And a swing and a miss. He struck him out. And a big out there as the go-ahead run stays at third with two gone now. Ready with the 1-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Ready with the 2-1. Fouled off. The set. And the 2-2. And he swings here and sends one in the air deep down the right field line.
Adolf
has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the side. Of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring up the outfielder Ross Adolph. Now the 1-1 pitch. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
1-2.
And a swing and a miss there on a late breaking slider as he set down on strikes for the second time this afternoon.
Second base.
So now into the box is Marwin Gonzalez. It was a walk in his last trip. Outside with the fastball as the count moves to 2-1 now. Swung out and missed, and it's even at 2-2.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
Fouled away. Slider gets him swinging, two gone. Now to the plate, Ronnie Dawson, who was retired after popping out in his last at-bat.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside. That's exactly what he did in his last at-bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over.
Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. And he lays lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now. Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. Here's the 2-2.
Ball.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Down the third baseline. On the first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Set to start the ninth in this one, and digging in is the outfielder Esteban Florial. The 1-1 misses ball two.
Hey, there's not a lot you can do with a slider breaking down and in unless you catch it way out front. I like the idea of taking it and making the pitcher bring you something a little more hittable.
It misses. 3-1 now. Miguel Andujar is on deck. He lays ball off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Now that
to the plate now is the designated hitter, Miguel Andujar. Go-ahead run at first, nobody out. Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. One pitch is a slider that's cut on and missed for strike two.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball, you could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Dawson will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. Next up, Mandy Alvarez is one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. The 1-1 pitch.
Ball.
On a good pitch there, had a correction to get out there, and it's 2-2 now.
He's staring a hat trick in the face right now after that swing. He has just got to find a way to zone up a little bit more. You cannot expect to make solid contact chasing stuff outside the zone.
Now a swing as he shoots this down the right field line, and that finds a seam for extra bases as we'll see if they want to wheel that go-ahead run home from first. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double. Brandon Belak takes over on the mound in a tie ball game. There is one gone here in the top of inning number nine.
Now pitching for the Steelers, number 64, Brandon.
Stepping in now, Rob Brantley. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And he fouls this one off. And a swing and a miss. He struck him out. And a big out there as the go-ahead run stays at third with two gone now. The set and the 1-1.
Outside, that's the ball.
It's a hard hit ball and caught over there at first. Almost big trouble there, but a wind up stranding two as the side is retired. Into the box, number 13. 0-for-2 with a walk for him so far. The 1-1. Doesn't catch the outside corner. It's a ball.
Two balls, one strike.
Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. And now, Jordan Brewer. He grounded out last time up. The 2-1 home.
That's the ball.
One out, nobody on. And a jam shot here as this is sent towards second. Fielded cleanly. And there's out number two. Next, it'll be Priudis Nova. Blasted a solo homer last time up.
And he certainly got a chance to end this one right here with another home run. Going to be interested to see the style, how he plays this one. Is he come back?
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. We are into extra innings, and that'll bring up the switch-hitting shortstop, Andrew Velasquez. Called strike, and he's behind 1-2.
1-2, count.
In the dirt, and now let's see. And he is in there at third as the possible go-ahead score. Here's the 2-2 pitch.
Full count.
Deep right field. Looking up is the right fielder, and they take the lead. It's gone. At the plate, Chris Gittens. And ooh, that strike zone's getting a little inconsistent now. It's 2-2.
Hey, be on the lookout right here. Usually when a pitcher drops in a curveball for a strike looking, now he'll try and throw it in the dirt, get you to fish a little bit. I want to see where he goes here.
And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
Now back.
Next, left here is Clint Frazier. Oh, they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Boy, that's a jam shot right there. That's as good as it gets, in my opinion. Woo, up and in.
Still only one out in the inning. The 1-2 is a breaking ball. They can't find the zone, and it's even at two.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
We've got ourselves an awesome battle going on right here. Bottom line, the guy who's going to win this situation is the guy who executes.
And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. Next, now it'll be Aaron Hicks. Flew out last time up. Hicks. Two out, nobody on. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And he strikes him out here for out number three, but the damage has been done as now they'll need some extra inning heroics to pull this one out. Garen O'Day enters the game here an inning later than usual as he'll try to close this one out in the 10th. Ready for the bottom of the 10th here, and digging in is the DH, the switch hitter, Robel Garcia. Lays off the slider that time, 2-1.
Watching him on the mound right now, I think he's just having trouble throwing strikes to this guy. Up only two runs, I don't think he's working around him.
2-2.
2-2.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
And it's fouled away. The 2-2. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Left fielder is on the move. He makes the play. Runner tags and heads for third. And a daring move there pays off as he'll make it into third on the fly ball to left. Big at bat now. And here is Garrett Stubbs. Though they might pitch around him here with a couple of bases empty. A bouncer to the left side. Reined in. Throw on the first to be in time, but meanwhile the lead shrinks to one here on the RBI ground ball. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Ross Adolph struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Oh, and he got a pitch to handle as this ball is hit high in the air and deep. And folks, this ball game is tied. Into the box, Marwin Gonzalez. And here's a slider that runs inside that time, and that'll keep him from diving out over the plate.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there, pretty much unable to hit any of his spots, and now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
Full count now, 3-2. Ready with the payoff pitch. And he strikes him out to retire the side, so we'll play at least one more. Brian Abreu takes the mound to start the 11th inning.
Skeeter, number 66.
Stepping in once again is Esteban Florial. It was a walk in his last trip. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two.
Really deceptive changeup right there. It died right before the plate, and he was left reaching for air.
Left fielder giving chase. He's there and records the first down. And that'll bring up Miguel Andujar. And a chance they walk him here to set up a double play that would keep the game tied. The 3-1 pitch.
Yeah.
Now a fastball gets down the upper court. Part of the zone for strike two.
He must know something we don't know. That was a center cut heater with count leverage in
that's
a big spot.
I
don't understand why he's taking.
And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Line to the right side. And that's through into right field for a base hit. He'll come home with it. Can't make the tag on him. He's safe. They've broken through to take the lead. At the plate now, Rob Brantley. Scooped up. There's one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. So now to the plate, Ronnie Dawson. They'll go to work on getting that tying run home from second. Here comes the 1-2.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
To two balls and two strikes now.
Two balls, two strikes.
sent on the ground out to second. Right to him. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Zach Britton comes on here looking to get the final two outs and earn the save.
Taylor Jones
will be his first assignment, and he's got a tough spot here with the runner at third and only one gone. Here's the 1-2. Swing and a fly ball. And this should at least get home the tying run. Catch is made. Here comes the tying run from third. Tag not in time. And we are once again tied in extra innings.
Number 13.
And stepping in, number 13. Bases empty and two gone following the sacrifice fly. A 1-2 pitch. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good. Up next, Jordan Brewer. Game on the line here, and a ball deep in the gap would make this place explode. The set and the 2-1. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. Hit out towards second. Fielded cleanly. On to first, and that'll mean a 12th inning is in order as this inning is over. On to the 12th frame in this one, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Tim LoCastro. Now the 2-1. Fastball is looked at for strike two.
2-2.
Grounded to third. He's got it. On to first. And how important is it to keep this guy off base in a tie ball game? One away. Big spot here. And it'll be Andrew Velasquez. And a chance they walk him here to set up a double play that would keep the game tied. And, oh, he's really given some leeway on the outside edge here. 2-2 now. And he got him. Now at the plate is Chris Gittens. Runner in scoring position with Sugan. One and one. Here it is.
No, that
sitting
missed.
In
that's
a good spot right here. Two ball,
two
one strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
2-1 pitch is a fastball.
Two.
Swung on and missed. 2-2.
I'm interested to watch this next pitch right here. He got a swing on a high fastball. I wonder if he's going to pull the old.
But we'll have to press pause. Is that strike three to retire the side? Chance to walk it off, and now here is Freudis Nova. The winning run stands at second base. Hit in the air to shallow center. Coming on for it is Hicks. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. Next up is Romel Garcia, and a chance they walk him here to set up a double play that will keep the game tied. Now the 1-2 pitch. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
The catcher.
So next to hit is Garrett Stubbs. And he's got a chance to bring in the winning run. Question is whether they'll even pitch to him. To two balls and two strikes now. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Strikes him out to retire the side, so we'll play at least one more. Riley Farrell takes the hill now to begin the lucky 13th inning. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Clint Frazier. He could use a hit here, 0 for 5 with three strikeouts. Not what he wanted to do there with the slider as it misses well above the zone. Oh. hot shot towards the hole. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard. And the go-ahead run will move up to third and wisely hold there with nobody out. To the plate now, Aaron Hicks. Oh, it's on the ground at second. Did he get his double play? I'm the first to complete the double play. Striding in is Esteban Florio, and he bats in a big spot here. Go-ahead run at third, two men out. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. Fouled off. And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
Lined into right field, and it's going to get down. A base hit. A big turning point here as they've taken a lead now deep into extra innings.
Now that designated hitter, Miguel Andujar.
Into the box now, Miguel Andujar. Hard on the ground toward short. Ah, way to get dirty and give it up on a phenomenal play to retire the side. Michael King comes in out of the bullpen as he'll finally try to wrap this one up in the bottom of the 13th. Leading off the inning, it'll be Ross Adolph, and they could use a spark from him here. Now the 1-1 pitch. Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side. Here comes the 1-2. In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. Hit hard on the ground at first. And this is through into right field, so the tying run's aboard to kick off the inning. Throw comes back into the infield as that tying run will hold up at third with still nobody out.
Second baseman.
Stepping in now, Marwin Gonzalez. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. And he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there. In now, Ronnie Dawson. Fouled away. Ready with another two-strike offering. And that's by him into right field for a base hit. The throw to the plate. And that's going to do it as they walk off as winners here in the 13th.
Hey, this game looked like it was going to be one of those wild ones right from the beginning. And when you could win this thing in walk-off fashion, what a way to win a ball game. A walk-off win?
A one-run game, 6-5, the final today. Riley Farrell takes home the win. So that'll just about do it for us this afternoon. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Fans, our final line score. First for the victorious Skeeters, 6 runs, 6 hits. No errors, they left 8 men on base. For the Rail Riders, 5 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They left 14 men on base. Time of the ball game, 4 hours and 29 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.